we want to graph y equals log base 2 of x by hand. To do this, we'll complete a table of values, which is always a good idea when trying to graph a function we're not familiar with. However, when graphing log equations by hand, it's often helpful to convert to the corresponding exponential equation. Recall that log base a of x equals y is equivalent to the exponential equation a to the power of y equals x. Notice to form the exponential equation, we can start with the base a and work around the equal sign, giving us a to the power of y equals x. Going back to our equation, y equals log base 2 of x, notice the equivalent exponential equation is 2 to the power of y equals x. From here, normally when completing a table of values, we select x values and determine the corresponding y value or corresponding output. But because our equation is 2 to the power of y equals x, notice it'll be much easier to select the y values than determine the corresponding x values. Let's go and select y equals negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. We can always select more y values if needed. Notice when y is equal to negative 1, we have 2 to the power of negative 1 equals x. Recall that 2 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 1 divided by 2 to the first or 1 half, giving us x equals 1 half. Next, we have y equals 0. When y is equal to 0, we have 2 to the power of 0 equals x, and therefore x equals 1. Next, we have y equals 1, giving us 2 to the power of 1 equals x. X equals 2. Next, we have y equals 2, giving us 2 to the power of 2 equals x, and therefore x equals 4. And finally, we have y equals 3, which gives us 2 to the power of 3 equals x. 2 to the third is 8, and therefore x equals 8. Let's go ahead and plot these 5 points and see if that's enough points to make a nice accurate graph of y equals log base 2 of x. We have 1 half comma negative 1, 1 comma 0, 2 comma 1, 4 comma 2, and 8 comma 3. This should be enough points to make a nice graph. Let's go ahead and select one more value of y. Let's see what's happening on the left by selecting, let's say, y equals negative 2. Notice if y is negative 2, then we have 2 to the power of negative 2 equals x, and x equals 1 divided by 2 squared, or 1 fourth, which would be approximately here. Notice the points are getting closer and closer to the y-axis, but they'll actually never touch the y-axis. Notice as y continues to decrease, we have y to a decreasing power, and therefore x is going to approach 0, but never reach 0, which indicates we have a vertical asymptote of x equals 0, which is the y-axis. Let's go ahead and graph the vertical asymptote as a dashed line, which again is just the y-axis. And again, the graph of y equals log base 2 of x passes through these 6 points, and on the left, the graph approaches x equals 0, or the y-axis. The graph looks something like this. Before we go, we also have some additional properties of functions or equations in the form of f of x equals log base a of x. The base a is greater than 0, x is greater than 0 as well, and a can't equal 1. If the base a is greater than 1, the function is increasing, which is our case. If the base a is between 0 and 1, the function is decreasing. The domain is the open interval from 0 to infinity. The range is the open interval from negative infinity to positive infinity. The vertical asymptote is x equals 0, which again is the y-axis, and the horizontal intercept is 1, 0, which our graph verifies. We can see that point here. I hope you found this helpful.